Hello and welcome to It's Only Electric. This is the Nissan Ariya 87 E-Force Stormtrooper Edition. I'm just kidding about the Stormtrooper thing. Looks like a Stormtrooper. All the black accents together with this white color. Looks good. A Stormtrooper in a good way. This video is about testing range, efficiency, acceleration, cabin noise. I have heard that this one should be really silent. And charging. How well and how fast will it charge between 10 to 80%? Let's start with some facts. E-Force stands for four-wheel drive, so two motors, one placed at the front axle, one at the rear. The combined power output, 301 horsepower, 600 newton meters of torque, the 0 to 100 in 5.7 seconds with a top speed of 200 kilometers per hour. And 87, that's the actual battery net capacity, so 87 kilowatt hours, and gross capacity 91. NMC battery pack. When it comes to charging, the charge port is placed here at the right front fender with a DC charging speed, fast charging, 130 kilowatts, 10 to 80%, around 40 minutes. Home charging, AC charging, three-phase support, 11 kilowatts. Equipped with a five-spoke designed 20-inch wheels, 255, 45 all around, so a non-staggered setup. In this case, Dunlop SP Sport Max tires, and the total range, this version, 498 kilometers of WLTP range. So the tires, of course, eats up a lot of range, and I think it's time to test the real consumption and the real range. This is the first stretch of the range and consumption test, just past 21 kilometers. Average consumption until now, just below 22 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers, so 21.7 in this case. A bit colder than I said earlier, so 9 degrees Celsius, total dry roads, no winds, so fairly good conditions for a good range. And the test cycle I drive is always the same. It's a 80 kilometers long test stretch with mixed speeds between 50 all the way up to 110 kilometers per hour. So average speed is 93 kilometers per hour. To create as comparable results as possible, I always stick to a certain set of rules. Rule number one, always stick to the actual speed limits, 60 in this case. Second rule, set the climate control to automatic and 20 degrees Celsius. That's also done. The last rule is to always drive on eco mode if that's available, and in this car it is. And the drive mode selector is actually placed here at front of the central armrest. So eco mode active, 20 degrees Celsius, sticking to the speed limits. That's all. And current consumption, 20.5 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers. So it's going downwards. Let's see where this ends. Will we be able to beat the stated range of 498 kilometers? Or will that be hard? Stay tuned. If you want to know more about the Nissan Ariya, I recently released a full review of it with more details than in this video. This video is not about reviewing the car as such. This is focusing on range, consumption, acceleration, noise, and charging specifically. So if you're interested in this car, you really should check that video out. I put the link up here. Feels like a fairly silent car, and it's also comfortable. So the suspension is not too stiff, more to the comfortable side. So pleasant on long road trips, I guess, and feels good. Also a silent cabin, double paned insulation glass, both here in the front and at the rear. Front windshield also seems to be heated, so that's good, especially on during winters and foggy days, misty days. So silent and comfortable are my two main words for the Nissan Ariya. Hitting the halfway, average consumption until now, 18.8 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers. 18.8, it has been dropping below 20 now, so that's good. And with this consumption, I think we'll be able to score a better result than the actual WLTP range. Let's see about that. So it's time to summarize. The final consumption ended up at 18.7 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers. That's okay, but not good. I mean, it's still pretty high when it comes to consumption for an electric car. Given the conditions, I hoped for some lower consumption. But anyway, that translates into a full range of 465 kilometers. Compared to the stated WLTP range, that's actually 90% of that. I mean, that's around what you can expect from out from this car. And if you want a version with longer range, higher efficiency, you should probably go for the big battery pack, but front wheel drive only. It's cheaper, more efficient, and has long range. That's up to you. Let's move on to the acceleration test. So the first 0 to 100 test, state of charge 87%, dry roads, good conditions, go.
Times 6.03 seconds. 0 to 100 kilometers per hour times 6.35 seconds.
State of charge 86%. Ready to go.
Zero to 60 miles per hour times 5.78 seconds. 0 to 100 kilometers per hour times 6.12 seconds.
Okay, 6.12. Specified time 5.7. Let's do a last test and see if we can get a bit of a better time. So the third attempt, state of charge 85%. Let's go.
0 to 60 miles per hour time 5.99 seconds. 0 to 100 kilometers per hour times 6.31 seconds.
Okay, 6.3. And as you saw, after a couple of runs, the best possible time I achieved was 6.12 seconds, 0 to 100 kilometers per hour, and 0 to 60 miles per hour, 5.87 seconds. So still somewhat a fast car, not meeting the specifications though. Stated 0 to 100 time from Nissan is actually 5.7 seconds, so 0.4 seconds away from the stated time. And this was at totally dry roads, good temperature, no wheel spin, and a state of charge of 87%. So it's hard to score a better acceleration time than this. And this is probably how it is. But still, I mean, it's tuned more to a comfortable side. You feel that in the suspension is fairly soft. And you also feel it when flooring the accelerator, because it picks up the power rather slow, and it's more comfortable than aggressive, I would say. So this car is not the one you buy to drive quick or to race with. Obviously, it's more a comfortable car. There is better performance versions of it out there, so you can get one with some more HP. Same setup, but more HP, probably more aggressive at start, that has a 0 to 100 time in 5.1 seconds. And there has been talks about even a more performance version of this one. But let's see about that. Let's move on to the noise test, the cabin noise measurement. And as always, I measure the cabin noise at passenger head height to be able to create a comparable result. I also always measure the noise on the same roads. Same road stretch, different speeds, 50, 70, 90, and 110 kilometers per hour. And this is the final result. And just to be clear, I also did cover the glass roof with the included cover or the curtain to be able to keep the noise level down in the cabin. I mean, the glass roof does, of course, replicate noise more than having it closed. So just to give you some understanding, compared to other cars, this is more noisy than the Volkswagen ID4 and the ID7. Not by much, but by a small margin. It's on par with the Hyundai Ioniq 5. So this is a silent car, and it's a lot more silent than the Tesla Model Y. It's also a tad more silent than the EX40, the Volvo EX40 or the Volvo XC40. It is a silent car, I mean, with the acoustic glass windows, both at the front and at the back. It's silent and comfortable, and the suspension also makes up for that, because it's all together, gives you a good driving comfort, I would say. It's time to have a look at one of the most exciting tests, and that's the charging. So charge from 10 to 80%. Stated top speed should be around 130 kilowatts according to Nissan themselves. So DC charging, fast charging. And I'm happy to report that at a state of charge of 42%, I actually achieved a top speed of 131, touching 132 kilowatts as a peak speed. And the interesting thing is that despite having a big battery pack with a gross capacity of 91 kilowatt hours, the top speed is rather low. I mean, it should be a bit higher, but maybe it's due to the chemistry or to save the battery longevity. I'm not sure, but it's kind of saved by the bell because it's a really flat charge curve. And this is the final charge curve I documented. And as you see, at 42%, 131 kilowatts, and very flat, kept the speed really good. And at 80%, it actually had a speed of 86 kilowatts. That's fairly impressive. I mean, a good speed at the end of the charge session. So total charge time, 33 minutes and 20 seconds. I mean, that's not that bad, actually. I was expecting a slower time than this. So I was ready to bash the charge curve, but I didn't. I mean, I think the final result is okay. And you don't need to spend that much time at the charger. One good thing, and one thing that I need to mention, is that I did the charge when it was 19, 20 degrees outside, so good weather conditions. And I actually preheated the battery pack and drove around for a while for preheating it. Didn't take that long, because I mean, warm weather. And I manually activated that on the screen. You can also activate the preheating by navigating to a fast charger. I think that's all for today. We looked at real range and consumption, charge curve, charge speed, cabin noise, and acceleration. And all in all, this seems to be a decent package. What do you think? Please share your thoughts in the comments below and let us have a discussion. And as I always say, very important aspects, like, engage, and subscribe. Super important for me. And on top of that, stay electric. Thank you for watching. Speak to you soon.